Yo guys,
what's up?
This is Psycho and it is finally here. My top 17 tips to play Alien Isolation.
Yo dude, IGN is going to hate this.
I heard IGN is not good at learning how to play games. I played this game for hundreds of hours and now it's time for you to get better at it. So let's roll it.
Let's go.
Tip number 1. Flamethrower usage. You may have noticed this yourself, that you are so happy to finally receive the flamethrower, only to notice that the fuel is gone faster than you can count to 3. If you struggle with fuel, I have an easy solution for you. You basically only need to know 3 things when it comes down to preserving your flamethrower fuel. Number 1, how much fuel do I need to make the alien go up the vent? Number 2, how do I dose the fuel usage? And number 3, at what distance do you need to flame the alien? Let's have a look at number 1, the amount of fuel you need to make the alien go away. This actually totally depends on the difficulty level you are on. On Nightmare, for example, you need around 60 fuel, and on Novice you need around 20 fuel to make him go away. Which brings us to number 2, how do you dose the fuel to the alien? The easiest way to do this is by simply doing small bursts with your flamethrower by tapping your fire key very quickly. The quicker the better, because the longer you stay on the button, the more fuel is wasted. If you try this on Nightmare difficulty, you will notice that one tap of the fire button will burn around 20 fuel. So if you do the math here, you need around 3 bursts to make the alien go away. Those 3 bursts totally depend on the distance to the alien though, as the flamethrower has a max range and not all the bursts may hit the alien fully. This is usually the case when you try to flame the alien as he's running towards you and you panic flame him. So this brings us to point number 3, the distance to the alien matters. Ideally, you want the alien to stand still while flaming him. If, however, you are not doing this correctly and it just stops, you may need a quick 4th burst to make him go away. This should be done very fast after the 3rd burst, as the alien regenerates its health quickly between the bursts. If you wait for too long between the bursts, you may need 5, 10 or 15 or even more bursts to make the alien go away. As I mentioned before, it is easier to do all this while he is standing still, and there are several ways to make him stop. The easiest way that doesn't use too much fuel is to just drag out the flamethrower and pointing it at him. If the alien is not too close while running at you, he should usually stop in time and go into a pretty long threatening animation which lasts 5 seconds. The way you can notice that the animation starts is by seeing him taking his right arm up, covering his face. Let's try this. The important thing here is to not stand in his way out to the next vent, otherwise he would instantly kill you. So it's good practice that you actually stay a little bit to the side to the next vent and then flame him like this. Threatening though only works once. After you've threatened him, he will actually get closer to you and closer to you until he will actually kill you. Here's the threatening animation. Then he will start walking towards you and he won't stop until you flame him. So you could go like this forever, but if you just stop, he won't stop anymore and he will kill you. There's another way to actually get around this, which I will show you later with the shotgun. There's another way you could make him quickly stop after the first threatening animation, and that is by just flaming him with one short burst, just like this. He won't go away, but you will have some time to get away from him and then walk away. You can repeat that quite a few times. Now you could actually even run. And then turn around again. But he won't go back into the threatening animation. Until you completely flame him 3 times. Let's say he's attacking you and he won't stop with the threatening and you just flamed him, but you didn't flame him enough. So he just goes into a stop animation and a little threatened animation. Do one more burst quickly right after that so he really goes away. Otherwise he could actually kill you because he didn't get enough damage from your first initial bursts. Just like this. You see, he went into a threatening animation. I didn't flame him enough. And then he went away after just one more small burst. Here is one small extra tip to save more fuel for the late game. If you don't reload your flamethrower before you give away your weapons in mission 13, you will receive back your flamethrower completely refueled with all the extra fuel that you picked up before in mission 14. So let's say you have found 200 extra fuel laying around, but you also use 200 of your 500 base fuel before mission 13. If you don't reload your flamethrower, you will get back 700 fuel in mission 14. If you reload, however, you will get back 500 fuel, so you will lose 200.
Wait! Yo, you there! Don't forget to like and subscribe!
Tip number 2. Shotgun stun. The shotgun actually stuns the alien for a little bit because the alien actually goes into a stun animation if you hit him correctly. While he's in this animation, you can actually also touch the alien without a problem and also run away during it. Stunt. Touch him. He's coming at us again. Stun. Touch him. And sometimes he even leaves because he has enough of our bullshittery. But then he comes back quickly. Stun, touch him, threaten him, reloads, stun. So you see, the actual shotgun stun actually resets the threatening count, so you can threaten him again after a shotgun stun, which is pretty neat. You can also use your stun to get away from the alien like this, and he actually loses track of you if he's not in line of sight. He will check out the locker though to see if you're in there. But that shouldn't be a problem, even on Nightmare. Please remember, no line of sight while you get into the locker and you should be Gucci. Tip number 3. Crouch hopping. So the normal way you could actually be completely silent in the game is just by crouching down. That way you are completely silent even when you're getting close to the alien. But as you notice, it is extremely slow. There's a small trick that we use in speedrunning where you could actually be a little bit faster than just crouching while also remain silent, and that is crouch hopping. By doing crouch hopping, you basically do nothing else than just spamming crouch while you are actually crouching. That way the character actually accelerates to walking speed almost until the character fully stands up. But if you press crouch again before the character fully stands up, you go back to crouching, and while you're doing that, the character stays completely silent without doing any footsteps. With crowd chopping, you will have a way easier time to get around the alien because you're faster. And to prove this, I will crowd chop right around the alien and he won't hear us at all. Tip number 4. Walking and hearing distance. So we've seen crouching right before. Crouching is completely silent while the alien is dropped down. Walking, though, is also completely silent when the alien is either in the vents or far away. He won't hear your steps, so you're perfectly fine to walk around like this while he is in the vents. And the way you know that he's in the vents is just by hearing the bumping noises in the vents. Once he drops down, you should be silent and go into crouch. You can actually complete the vast majority of the game by just walking to your objective. Sometimes there are scripted drops where the longer you wait, he will drop more and more. But usually if you are fast to the objective, he will not drop at all and you won't even see him. To check the walking distance of him hearing you, you could do a very easy test by just walking towards him. See that? That was already the radius that he could hear me. And then you're dead. But if you walk outside of that radius, you should be completely fine without him hearing you. It is different though if you're running. Running is always heard by him by a long distance. Tip number 5. Breadcrumbs of noise and distractions. All the enemies in Alien Isolation are very noise sensitive, so they usually check out the last spot where they heard a loud noise. So if you remain completely silent after you made a loud noise, he would actually not be able to track you down. This allows you to play around with him and actually make him go to where you want him to go. To demonstrate this, I'm just banging this wall here. And then I'm walking away. Remember, he cannot hear me walking. Then as soon as he drops, I'm remaining silent with crouching. And as you can see, he will actually go to the last spot he heard a noise. And that was actually me walking a little bit. He heard me a little bit walking. But usually, he will check out the area where he heard something like that. And then you could use something like a flare to make him go for the flare, because flares are usually not making him drop out of the vent. Flares are silent, but if you use a wrench hit or even running in combination with a flare, you could have him right where you want him, right? Same goes for this. If I make noise here, and then I remain silent, made a hit and he checked out the spot where he heard the noise. He can't find me though. Just around the pillar, boy. The same goes for you hiding in lockers apparently. If you threaten him and then run for a locker, if you are not in line of sight, he can only track you down to the locker and then he loses track of you. The same mechanic, he only follows the breadcrumbs of noise he hears and then goes into his search routine trying to find you. Usually this will end up in him sniffing the locker you are in, because he's clever, remember? But you should be usually fine even on Nightmare. There are many different distractions you could use. One of them is the flare, as I already showed, which actually doesn't make the alien drop, so that only works in conjunction with him already being dropped. The noisemaker, which actually makes him drop and will also make him check out the noisemaker itself going into an animation. The smoke bomb only works if he's really close and hears it, but he won't actually check out the smoke bomb with an animation. So he will just hover in that area where he heard that smoke bomb going off. If he hears it, he has to be really close to actually hear that. The flashbang works the same as a noisemaker. The EMP also works the same as a noisemaker. The Molotov also works the same as a noisemaker. The pipe bomb also works the same as a noisemaker. So to demonstrate this, I will throw an EMP to drop the alien, and the alien will actually go and check out that EMP where it went off, like it would be for a noisemaker. So the alien goes into that checkout animation. And after it's checked it out, he will go into his search routine again. Distractions like this are actually a great tool to get away from him and continue with your objective, while not having the alien on your ass 24/7. While he's in his animation, he's occupied for a little bit. And you can just continue doing what you should be doing. Just remember that he will actually ignore too many distractions from the same type. So if you throw three flares, for example, he won't be interested in the third flare anymore until you actually flame him and he goes up the vent again. Tip number 6. Places where the alien can't reach you. There are some places in Alien Isolation where the alien is actually not able to physically reach you. One of them, for example, is this vent here in Mission 7. If you open this vent once the alien is attacking you, he is coming. He cannot actually reach you. So he actually needs to retreat into the vents again. While he's doing that, you can also even touch him. The reason why that is there's not enough space for the alien model to actually walk past this vent, and the game actually decides that the alien cannot walk over opened vents. So he has to turn around and upwind again. And while he's in this lock-on mode, you're completely safe to just run away from him. Also a lot of rooms in this game which can be locked and which have no vent opening for the alien, so I could basically lure the alien to you . Close it down, and if you make a lot of noise now, he needs to upvent again because there's no vent opening in this room . Open the door again, and then just basically continue to the next room. You could do the same game again. It takes some time though to actually get to you. Same game again, he cannot get to me. There's no vent opening in here. Open it again. And as you can see, he won't even do anything. The same goes for trams. This is the M17 tram to the next section. There's no vent opening here. The alien cannot drop in here. But the alien is still active, so I'm just making a lot of noise until the door opens. which actually allows me to just run to the next elevator without him dropping. So the director AI actually tries to make the alien drop, but he gives him a little bit of delay because he could not reach you in that tram. And that way you were actually fine to just run to the next elevator. Tip number 7, the floor vent lure. In Alien Isolation, floor vents actually become pretty handy. If the alien is dropped, like this here, you can actually lure the alien into the vent by simply making noise in the vent, either by an item like a noisemaker or even with the revolver. That way the alien actually needs to upvent, and while he's upventing, you can get out and do your thing, whatever that should be. The alien is actually delayed in the vent because he's searching for you, and that way you can actually escape from him. You can use this strat, for example, here in mission 10. Once you press that button over there, get in the vent, wait till the door actually opens, make noise in the vent, and then just get out. Tip number 8, the android stun. So you can actually stun the androids so that they don't attack you with a revolver or a shotgun, even with the flamethrower, it actually works. The only thing you have to do is run at them. You can even just wait for them to come at you. Get the revolver out, stun them, and just run past them. If you have a second android or a third android right after him, he will only punch you because there's a cooldown for all the androids around for them not to grab you. And that cooldown is about, I would say, it's somewhere around 8 seconds or so until they will grab you again. So this actually is pretty great because a punch does way less damage than a grab. So it's about half the damage that you get. So stunning them is a great way to get around these destroyers. And that's how you do it, right? Sometimes you don't even get punched by the other droid because he's getting confused. And that's how you stun the normal chows. With the heavy chows, it's different though. So with the super chows, your timing has to be much more precisely than with the normal chows. You cannot just stun them with a shot and then run past them. You have to stun them while he's starting his grabbing animation. Otherwise, he would actually grab you and you would lose a lot of damage. Let me show you what I mean. So here we have a super chow, right? And as soon as he starts his grabbing animation, I'm shooting him, and then he doesn't grab me, right? They have the same cooldown as the normal chows, so 8 seconds till they will grab you again, also in a group, same thing. The other ones will hit me, but you're fine, you can just pass them, right? This guy will hit me as well, because we are still in the cooldown, and that's it. That's how you stun the super chows. And by the way, not only the shotgun works, revolver works as well. Tip number 9, killing an android the effective way. Let's start with the super chows. Super chows are killed with the bolt gun with one simple headshot. Load it up, release it, and he's dead. The second weapon you can use to kill a super chow is a shotgun. 3 precise shots to the head with the shotgun and the super chow is gone. What you can also do to damage them before you actually use the shotgun on them is to just throw a pipe bomb at them. That way they will have way less health once you get on them with the shotgun, and you only need about one shotgun shot to actually kill them. Let me show you this. Now you could also use the revolver on them, but I wouldn't advise it, because you need so many bullets to actually kill them. It's absolutely ridiculous, so I wouldn't advise doing that at all. If you have problems, by the way, in this part here, just try to lure them all the way around while doing the things and the mini games up there, and if they follow you through, just run away again and lure them around again. Killing normal Joes is actually way easier. On Nightmare you need about 6 revolver bullets to the head and he's gone. Let me try this. Once you have a shotgun, an android kill is actually super easy. Just aim for the head, shoot once, and then use your wrench. Same thing again. Aim for the head. One wrench it and he's dead. Tip number 10. Lean into objects. So in Alien Isolations you have a lot of crates standing around. You can use them to lean into them while an enemy is around. Enemies have specific view cones where they actually see you, and if he's passing you, he may not see you. If you're actually lowering your visual profile by leaning into objects just like this. So I'm just using my P key at this crate here and I'm leaning around it. See that? The alien actually turned right there. I was actually in his line of sight, but he didn't see me because I was leaning into the crate here, which is pretty funny. So keep a low profile by leaning into objects. Tip number 11, the flashbang stun. Flashbangs can actually stun the alien for quite a bit of time, so you can get away from him while he's stunned. You do that by just laying it down where you want it, just like that, as a bomb. You can even lay down more than one, of course. Number 1 triggered, number 2 triggered, number 3 triggered. So the stun is not as long as a threatening stun, but it always works. You can also stun him by throwing the flashbang at him, but that is way harder to do and it usually doesn't stun him at all. Tip number 12, smoke bombs. Smoke bombs are actually pretty useful when you're around the alien, because he cannot really see you in a smoke bomb. And you can get pretty close to him. Just stay completely silent while you do that, otherwise he will hear you and he will kill you. Smoke bombs are actually great if you use it in front of generators, for example, where there are aliens around. So that they will not kill you while you are at the generator. As I already mentioned, he hears the smoke bomb going off when he's really close to it, but he will not go into his checkout animation. He will just check out the area where the smoke bomb went off. You can even use your smoke bomb in conjunction with the shotgun to escape, and I will show you how. It is a little bit harder to do, but it usually also works. You can also do this with the flamethrower threatening, which actually gives you a little bit more time to evade the alien. Arms up. And you're gone. He falls back into his search routine, but he has really no idea where we are. Tip number 13. Silent stun button kills. In missions like this here, mission 17, it's crucial to be completely silent so the alien doesn't drop. So if you have other enemies than the alien, just use your stun button on them to not alert the alien. Humans are instantly dead. You can even kill facehuggers like this one here in mission 17 with the stun button. Go into crouch position and kill him like this. You have to kill him while he's flying at you, otherwise he would hug you. But that way you actually stay completely silent and the alien won't drop. Tip number 14. Kill huggers with the wrench. In case you didn't know, you can actually kill the huggers with your wrench. You just have to time it correctly, swing the wrench, and the hugger is gone. This will make a lot of noise though, so keep an eye out for the alien after that. I also need to note, if you kill the hugger like this, you will take acid damage from the hugger. So only do this if you are sure you have enough health for it. Tip number 15. Use the environment to your advantage. There's a lot of cylinders laying around in this game, even fire extinguishers that you can use to scare away the alien and actually save flamethrower fuel. So if you make the alien drop, take out the revolver, shoot the cylinder, and he's gone. That way you save a lot of flamethrower fuel and the alien is gone for a little while. The same will work for fire extinguishers that you see around and other gas canisters, of course. You can use radios on this station to draw his attention. And he's going to check them out just like he would with a noisemaker. You can even use the accessory wires on the wall to draw the attention to a certain place mapped on the accessory wire. And for example, I'm using the speaker system here, which will actually draw the attention to that certain spot with some noise. You can even use the air purification system to actually make you less visible, like within a smoke bomb. And you have a lot of stealth options with the accessory wires, so use them if you have troubles getting around them without using your items. Tip number 16. Use the EMP to stun humans. So this is probably something a lot of people don't know, but you can actually stun humans for just a little bit to get closer to them to actually kill them. This is especially useful against revolver humans, especially on Nightmare, because they kill you at a large distance. So this will help you to get closer to the revolver humans and then actually kill them with whatever you like, a shotgun, wrench, whatever it is. Let's show the stun in action.
You've got company. Caesar security just came through. Guns in hand, not friends.
What do they want?
The turrets.
See, he's stunned. And now he's reinstated.
Can they?
No, Quant is still out.
Let me see where the other revolver dude is. He's probably over there. Let me stun this guy again. See that? Both are actually stunned. And then they are reinstated. Sometimes the stun doesn't work anymore. But then you can actually get close to them and kill them with whatever you like. Tip number 17. Silent walking. So this is a major glitch apparently, but I still want to mention it. In case all other things fail, you can still use it, and you probably already use it sometimes without even knowing it that you're using it. So it's still a mention that I need to make, and here is how you do it. So silent walking is actually pretty easy. You just press W and D on the PC. On the console it's probably just forward and right at the same time, and that way you go diagonally without making any noise. This is silent walking. In speedrunning we will also have another technique called psycho running or silent running that I'm not explaining right here because it's probably too much of a hassle for casual players, but this is actually a pretty nice way to get around the alien, and it's completely silent, just like crouching or crouch hopping. But you will go at full walking speed or completely silent. This only works to the right side, not to the left side. See, you can still hear the steps. But this here is actually completely silent.
Wait, is it over yet? What? You're still here? Holy shit, you legend. Thank you so much for watching. By the way, don't forget to subscribe. And check out my other content. I need to go!